Hey everyone, so we are out here and we are exploring Cincinnati Art Museum today. So I thought it'd be really fun to just go ahead and get a compilation of quite a bit of the artwork, just kind of put it all together so you guys can see it. Because the main reason is they switch artwork around a lot at this museum, so chances are if you ever make it down here, the artwork's going to be totally different. So I thought it'd be fun to kind of get a time lapse and then get a bunch of the different artwork and put it together. Thankfully, they actually allow you to record for most parts of this museum, so I am going to be able to put this together for you. And I am going to put this at the end of the video because it is quite lengthy, and I know a lot of people aren't into more lengthy vlogs, so I'm going to put this at the end. But for now, let's go ahead, let's get started.
Hey, just running to the
Thank you.
resistor right here, this R2. Remember, a lot of times the resistor we're going to be dealing with is labeled R2. That's going to be this one right here. This one's really unique. You can actually see the pathway right here, and it almost gives us an option here. I'm going to tilt it so I can see it a bit better, but if you see it, this piece right here, we could actually solder onto that. Now, we do have to be really careful with soldering onto that, because remember, these boards do come up quite a bit. But we have this right here. We just scratch down the surface just a tiny bit and solder right onto this little bed right here. And that's going to give us the option to actually solder onto the other side of this over here, which we may actually be able to scratch that down as well. Same thing, solder right onto that bed as well. Then after that, so now we have these two beds right here, we can go ahead and solder on. That's going to be both sides of the resistor. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Once we do that, we are going to need to secure this really fast, because these boards come on very, very easy. So I'm going to go ahead and solder both wires. So this instrument isn't super ideal as far as finding the pitch control and even planning the pitch control and stuff, because it's very sensitive, so it really crashes when you touch that midpoint a lot. And then another thing is we need resistors on both sides in order for it to not crash. So I made this resistor bundle right here. This is just three separate resistors running parallel. It works, and then as you've seen, this also is a reverse polarity instrument, which commonly when you find these things, they will give you problems. So what I mean by reverse polarity is that normally when we hook into the positive for the resistor, the pitch goes up. Well, this one is actually going to go down, whereas the other way, when you hook into the ground, is going to for some reason bring it up. Now, I don't know why that is. You know, I'm not the best when it comes to explaining this stuff in a I guess electronic standpoint. I'm more of an experimentalist when it comes to electronics, so I don't know the exact reason it does that, but I do come across these once in a great while, and this one just so happens to be it. And when I do come across these, they very often are a pain in the butt to actually do. But we got it all set up now. It doesn't have an insanely high... Let me get it to play again. Let me get the better one. Doesn't have an insanely high pitch to it. But it is higher and it's stable. And the bottom's stable. So that's really nice. Because that's exactly what we're looking for. So we're looking for a stable instrument that's not going to crash all the time when we don't have to pull the batteries out. So, now we have the stock switch installed. We have a power on and off switch. And we have a tempo tone control. So the next thing we're going to go ahead and install is we're going to go ahead and install a pro sound. And then we're going to see if we can hook some LEDs in this guy.
Words and ideas can change the world. A secret for you. We don't read and write poetry because it's cute. We read and write poetry because we are members of the human race. And the human race is filled with passion, beauty, romance, love. These are what we stay alive for. Life exists in identity. But the powerful play goes on in you. Let me contribute first. The powerful play goes on in you. May contribute a verse.
Absolutely crazy. Definitely not something you want to get into if you're a beginner. So if you see this on the shelves and you're just starting out, definitely would not recommend this instrument. So this is really sensitive, and when you actually touch the speaker wires, it crashes. When you feed it directly into a pro sound, it crashes. If you feed it directly into an LED, it crashes. So not only did we have opposite polarity, we also had the pretty limited range of motion as far as not crashing. But we also are now dealing with this, which is the crashing of the pro sounds and stuff. But what we can actually do here is we can add some resistors. So these are pretty large resistors and as far as ohmage and resistance. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and add both of these in here. And then I did pre-test these before running the camera, because I have a resistor bag that's an absolute mess. And you're probably wondering, well, why don't you get organized? I don't really know. I have all of these resistors, and I'm kind of a frugal person, so I don't want to throw them away. But also, at the same time, I waste a lot of time just kind of trying out resistors. But what we're going to do is we're going to put these two resistors on each side of this Pro Sound. And that's going to actually allow us to get the pro sound from here without it crashing. Because when we feed it directly to the amp, it's just going to crash every time. But a circuit instrument without a pro sound is not awesome. It's kind of, I don't know, I just always see the pro sound as like a staple of circuit bending. So without it, it kind of just feels like a naked instrument. It doesn't really feel completed to me. So we're going to go ahead and add this in. And this should work for us. All right, so that is set.
Thank you.